Hi everyone, this is Mrs. Pearson, your elementary ELL teacher. Today we're going to work on the informative oral retell. That means you're going to retell important details from or for the second grade journeys, lesson 25. And our anchor text is From Seed to Plant by Gail Gibbons. So for this lesson, we're going to turn and talk. That means I'm going to ask you a question. You're going to think about the answer. You're going to pair up with a partner at home, or you can be my virtual partner, and you're going to share your thinking out loud in a complete sentence or sentences. So from seed to plant is either fiction or, fiction is literature, or nonfiction, and nonfiction text is informational. So literature is made up, whereas informational has true facts. Literature, you need to read in order, whereas informational, you can read in any order. Fiction entertains readers. Nonfiction teaches readers. Fiction has illustrations. Nonfiction has photographs or illustrations. Just like in From Seed to Plant, there are very realistic illustrations. Fiction has characters, setting, problems, solutions. It tells a story. Animals can talk. It has a beginning, middle, and ending. Nonfiction has text features like table of contents, photographs, a heading, charts, diagrams, labels, captions, an index, and glossary. So, From Seed to Plant is nonfiction. Again, what does that mean? Nonfiction books teach us information and facts. Nonfiction is real. It has text features like photographs, and real topics might be holidays, animals, and sports. Here's our first learning target. I can tell the main topic and key details of the text from seed to plant using pictures and words. Here's our second learning target. I can listen and take turns when I'm having a conversation about the text. So you're going to talk about the text in your own words. Success criteria. That means how will you know you're successful at telling the main topic and key details of the text? And how will you know you're successful at listening and taking turns and talking about the text? Well, here are your steps to success. I will. Answer the talk about it questions. I will. Circle and say what the author's purpose of the passage is. I will. Say and match what the text is mostly about. The most important thing. I will. Say and match what the author wants us to learn. And then finally, I will say and match 1 to 2 detail sentences to each retelling picture. Let's go over our turn and talk rules. Number one, eye to eye and knee to knee. Make sure you're facing the person you're talking to. Number two, first one person talks, the other person listens. Three, then the next person talks, the other person listens. 4, do not talk too long on your turn or your partner will not have time to have a turn. You may agree with me or the person you're with, and you could say, I agree with you because, and tell me or your partner why. Or you may disagree with myself or with me or your partner and say, I disagree with you because, and tell us why. Let's go over our important vocabulary words because you may be saying these in sentences. So number one is grain. Grain is a small piece of something. It's a kernel or seed. Number two, pod, a shell that covers seeds, pod. Number three, soak, completely wet with liquid, immersed or covered in water. Number four, soften, make softer and less hard, cushioning. Number five, root, the tube-shaped part of a plant that draws up water and minerals. A plant part that grows down to get water. Number six, a shoot, a sprout, or plant that has just begun to grow. Number seven, nutrition, what a body needs to grow and keep healthy, nourishment. Number eight, tasty, has good flavor, yummy, like yummy in my tummy. So here's our first important detail from the text. You can see that there's a picture with a lot of labels. You can find it on pages 352 or 351 to 352 of our Second Grade Journeys textbook. And on the picture, there is the petal, which is the pink part, the sepal, which is the bottom near the stem, which is the bottom green shoot. And it says, number one, here's your question. What part of a flower makes pollen? What part of a flower makes pollen? Where does the pollen need to go? So first, let's read this labeled picture. Stamens make yellow powder called pollen. That's what it says, and it's pointing to the stamens. And then the sticky part at the top of the pistil is the stigma. So, what part of the flower makes pollen, and where does the pollen need to go? So, the blank makes the pollen, and pollen must land on the... So, I highlighted the text evidence that will help you answer this question. What part of a flower makes pollen? Where does the pollen need to go? The blank makes the pollen. Pollen must land on the blank. So the stamens make the pollen. Pollen must land on the stigma, which is on the pistil. In what part of the flower do seeds begin to grow? In what part of the flower do seeds begin to grow? And if you read this part, it says at the bottom of the pistil are tiny egg cells called ovules. At the bottom of the pistil are tiny egg cells called ovules. So in what part of the flower do seeds begin to grow? Seeds begin to grow in the... Well, seeds begin to grow in the ovules. Here's our next important detail. You can reread it about in our textbook on pages 353 to 356. What protects the seeds as they become bigger? What protects the seeds as they become bigger? The blank protects the seeds as it gets bigger. Well, the fruit or pods protect the seeds as they get bigger. What are some ways that seeds spread? What are some ways that seeds spread? You can look on the picture here. There's different pictures that show how seeds spread. Some ways that seeds spread are... Well, in the first top left picture, seeds spread by the wind, because some seeds have fluffy parts on them, which help them float. Other seeds have wings, which make them turn around and as they fall to the ground. So the wind helps seeds spread. Water, like rivers, ponds, lakes, help seeds spread until they get to some dirt on the side of the water. Animals help seeds spread. They scatter the seeds when they bury them in the ground, for example. Birds also eat berries and then spread the seeds. People even spread seeds because some seeds have hooks that stick to both animals and people. You see those seeds on the person's pants because they have those hooks. Here's our next important detail. You can reread about it on page 359. And there's a picture with some labels: germination, root. What is germination? Germination is when. What is germination? Germination is when. Well, germination is when the seed coat is soaked in water and it softens and the seed coat breaks open. And when the seed coat breaks open, the seed coat breaks open when the soil is warm from the sun. So once the seed coat breaks open from the warm soil, then a root grows, and this is called germination. What happens in order as the seed begins to grow? First, then last. Well, I kind of already told you the steps, so if you remember, first, then last. Well, first the seed coat is softened from the rain, then it breaks open, and in the warm soil that's warmed from the sun, and then last a root grows. Here's our last important detail. You can reread about it on pages 359 to 360. What does a plant need to grow? What does a plant need to grow? So a plant needs blank and blank and blank to grow. What are some things a plant needs to grow? Well, a plant needs sun. A plant needs water. A plant needs nutrients from the soil, and a plant needs leaves because the leaves help make the food for the plant. What grows on the plant that helps to make seeds? And you see the picture with the label, and that will tell you the answer. What grows on the plant that helps make seeds? Blank grows on the plant, which open into blank. Well, buds grow on the plant, which open into flowers. And if you remember, inside the flower is the ovule, which makes the seed. Why did the author write the text from seed to plant? Well, it's as easy as pie, or P-I-E. That's our acronym. The author wrote the text to either persuade. P stands for persuade, and persuade means to convince the reader of a certain point of view. Inform, I stands for inform. Inform means to teach or give information to the reader. Or entertain, E stands for entertain, to hold the attention of the reader through enjoyment. Main idea. What is the main idea? The main idea is what a text is mostly about. To get clues about the main idea, you can look at the title of the text and pictures. Sometimes the main idea is in the first and last sentence. Look for clue words repeated over and over. Retell of the important details from seed to plant. The author wrote the text to either persuade, inform, or entertain the reader. Why did the author write From Seed to Plant? Was it to persuade the reader of a certain point of view, to convince them of something? Or was it to inform the reader, to give information? Or was it to entertain the reader about a story, about something? Well, the author wrote the text to inform, to give information. And what is that information? It's mostly about the main idea. It's mostly about how seeds grow into plants. So what is the main idea? It's mostly about how seeds grow into plants. So it's informing the reader of how seeds grow into plants. Here are four details or facts that support the main idea. Remember, we've already talked about these four important details. So first, what did we learn on this page or with this picture with all its labels? So first, there are many parts of, what are there many parts of? There are many parts of a There are many parts of a flower. The stamen makes the pollen. A grain of pollen must land on the sticky stigma before a seed can start to grow. So first, there are many parts of a flower. The stamen makes the pollen. A grain of pollen must land on the sticky stigma before a seed can start to grow. Second, the fruit or pod grows around. What does the fruit or pod grow around? And how do, you can also think of, how do seeds travel? Well, the fruit or pod grows around a seed and protects it. Once the fruit or pods ripen, the seeds are scattered by animals, people, and the wind, and also water. Third, what is germination? Remember this, there's the word germination with root. So there's the picture with the labels. Third, germination is when. Germination is when a seed coat breaks open and sprouts. From there, a root grows down in the soil to get water and minerals. With this food, it can grow a shoot. Fourth, once a plant has grown, it has Once a plant has grown, it has buds, which open into flowers. The parts of a flower help make new seeds. These seeds, pods, or fruit are tasty and full of nutrition. In conclusion, the author wants us to learn. What does the author want us to learn? In conclusion, the author wants us to learn about how it's related to our main idea. In conclusion, the author wants us to learn about how plants grow or how seeds grow into plants, which was our main idea. All right. I want you to think about your learning today. How did we hit the learning target? I can tell the main topic and key details of the text from seed to plant using pictures, words, and sentences. Could you give yourself a 4? I could teach this lesson. I was able to answer all the talk about it questions and complete the graphic organizer. Or would you give yourself a 3? I was able to answer most of the questions and complete the graphic organizer. Or would you give yourself a 2? I was able to answer some of the questions and complete some of the graphic organizer, or say it. Or 1, I had a hard time completing the graphic organizer and answering the questions. How do you think you did? 4, 3, 2, or 1? All right. Thank you for talking about the main idea and important details of the text from seed to plant. Have a great day.